So what are your choices? You can bid two clubs. I don't like that. Put an ace here. And take this ace away. And give me a jack. Now I might bid two clubs. I think that it shows what I have. Yes, I do risk losing the heart suit.
My question kind of backed up to when you had it before, when you had your tolerance for spades, when you had your ace.
I still have tolerance. Three cards is still
when they did the spade, your next bid is you'd have to pass a raise.
Pass a raise. Mm-hmm. I don't have enough to do anything else.
Right. Pass or you said pass or raise.
Yes.
So what
if and if this person, if this person bids a spade.
Right.
So we get one diamond down here.
Tony's bid a diamond, you double, and your partner bids a spade.
I've doubled, partner bids a spade.
Okay.
Let's say this person bids, he's not gonna bid clubs, is he?
Yeah, nope.
Let's say he bids two diamonds. Mm-hmm. What do I do? I'm gonna make a suggestion. Double. Shot, it kind of shows I have three of your suit. It's kind of a support double.
It's a support double.
Yeah, it's not your traditional support double, but it's a support double.
Okay.
Two doubles.
What about half a spade fit with the double that says I have on 256?
Well, it still says the same thing. You still have the unbid suits. So let's say partner might have five spades and four hearts. He'll come back and bid the hearts, and we'll be fine. But I definitely cannot bid two hearts over my partner's one spade. I definitely cannot bid one diamond. That's kind of why I like doubling with this hand. I mean, bidding two clubs with this hand, because it avoids those rebid problems down the road. If partner changes suits, I've got support, don't I? We're gonna talk about that in a little bit. Okay. You can overcall a no trump with one or both four card majors. When you overcall a no trump, what are the two things you're promising? Stopper in the bid suit. Probably one and a half.
With a suit bid?
When right-hand opponent bids a suit to overcall one no trump, I promise I have their suit. It's not a good idea to overcall a no trump without that suit, because if they lead, then what? I mean, they're gonna run all over you, especially if you have a singleton. So if I have a no trump hand in high card points and a stopper in their suit, I can overcall a no trump. I've told my, you know, anytime you bid no trump, you've told your partner so much about your shape and your strength. That's the advantage of bidding a no trump. So if I do that with one or both four card majors, partner is still at liberty to bid two clubs and let me bid my four card major, because our systems are on. Does that make sense? He pretends this yo-yo bid, but we're ignoring him. Partner bid a no trump. That's who I'm going to believe. And if over a one no trump opening, I would bid stamen or transfer, I do so. Or raise. You might have 9 points. So you just raise your partner to two no trump. He's on the top, he's gonna say three. Again, this hand is between us. Their cards are trapped. I know where every card is. All the missing cards. I have a no trump opener, and that one has nine. This person's pretty broke, right? And I'm behind him. That's where I like to be, in the finessing position. Okay, I'm going to introduce a new concept for most of you, I think, called equal level conversion.
If I double, my partner doesn't take out double, what's the point that I have to have to jump in the two levels at 10 or more or 9 or more?
I didn't get into your responses, but I'll tell you, I think with a good 8, but I like 9. I like 0 to 8, I get at the lower level. With 9 or 10 points, I jump a level.
Okay.
If this person bids, I jump would show it stronger, because if you free bid, you're showing something. Mm-hmm. When you bid over my takeout double, you may have 0, you had to bid. But if it goes 1 diamond double, 2 diamonds, 2 hearts, they have hearts and values, at least 7 or 8 points. They don't need to jump to show that it was a free bid. And then a jump would show at least an invitational hand of 10 to 12.
Okay. So 0 to 8, you bid whatever you
bid at the lowest level.
Right. And 9 plus.
You jump a little.
You jump.
All right. Yes.
And then you Q-bid if you have the full.
And then if you have an opener, because partner should have an opener for a takeout double, you Q-bid.
Okay. And advancer has an opener.
Advancer Q-bids with an opener.
Not the same as that.
Is advancer is the responder to the takeout double.
Okay, and that's different Q-bidding than what you were showing up there.
Yes.
And how does that work?
Okay, let's look at this. Let's try it. I didn't instruct the hand like this, but let's get 1 diamond. And what am I having for my takeout double? Let's see. I'll just do something like this. I have both majors. I've got a singleton diamond, and I have my set. And I have my say about 12 points. Mm-hmm. So, 1 diamond, double. Let's give partner this hand.
That's the diamond. Okay.
7, 11, 12. I'll give him a jack. 4, 4, 3, 2. Okay?
Okay, this is partner.
This is the advancer.
Okay. Partner to the double. Okay.
The partner of the doubler or the overcaller is called the advancer. This is called the opener. And this is called the responder. Just to differentiate what role you're playing in this particular hand. 1 diamond, double. Oh boy, partner. You're going to be happy with my hand. So, because partner could have made the double with that, you don't want to jump to 4 hearts. You know you have a game, but you're not sure where it should be. So, well, let's leave it like this. You bid 2 diamonds. Take your pick, partner. I've got them both. Because our double the minor pretty well promises majors. Tolerance or support. In this case, what are we going to do? Bid 4 spades. An opener.
Now, opener did 1 diamond, and what did we do?
No. I doubled. I made a takeout double.
Okay. And then they bid the 2 diamonds.
And they Q-bid to say, okay, I want you to pick the suit, partner. But we have, it's our hand. Mm-hmm. It's our hand. You need an opener or close to it. Again, if your shape is perfect, I'd do it with that. Because if partner bid a heart or a spade, wouldn't I want to go to game with that hand? So how good do you have to be to Q-bid when your partner makes a takeout double? Something that you'd be in game with the open.
Okay.
So again, it's high card points and shape.
Okay, so the doubler comes back with two spades.
No.
He goes right to.
No, I did four spades. Yeah, I just bid four spades.
But that doesn't tell you that you answered four spades.
The cubic?
The advancer.
Yes, it does.
Yes, it does.
Because if he has only one. Okay, he has only one, he's not gonna cubic. He's gonna bid three hearts or something. So when he doubles, he says, you know, it's kind of like, where do you wanna go for dinner? Chinese. Oh, I had Chinese for lunch. Where else do you wanna go? Oh, let's go Italian. Nah, you know, I hate pasta. You know, bidding is like that. You don't want to tell your partner anything you like if you don't mean it. If you say, bid your best suit, you're going to like my hand, you need to mean it. Okay? And consequently here, if partner doesn't mean it, he shouldn't cube it. If he has a suit, he shows it. If you have a preference, show it. This is no preference, but points. And I have support, not tolerance, support for both majors. You've got one major, bid it. Okay? Double is flexible in that it allows partner to choose. But you don't want partner to choose if you have a preference. You want to tell him what you have and see if he can support it. You know, there's something called he who knows shows. If I know I have spades, I better show them when partner asks me to bid a major. He who knows goes. Don't invite if you have a force, just bid it. So when we ask partner to choose, it should be because we don't know where we should play. We don't know how high we should play. We don't know where, we don't know how high. That's when we make our vague bids, like double or invite or whatever. You don't invite with a game force hand, you just bid it. Now, can I talk about equal level conversion?
Can you break first?
You want to break?
Oh, 10 o'clock.
It's 11 o'clock. 10